Have you ever heard of the Great Lakes? No, not the ones in the US and Canada, though Lake Michigan does happen to be one of my favorites. I'm talking about the African Great Lakes, Lake Edward, Lake Kivu, Lake Malawi. Well, there's something really weird happening in that last one. This lake has more than 850 species of one type of fish. That's more than the total number of species of fish in all of Europe's freshwater systems. So what the heck is going on in Lake Malawi? Not long after Charles Darwin made it to the Galapagos Islands and began studying the famously diverse finches there, news arrived in Europe that a massive body of water had been discovered in southeastern Africa. Of course, the people who had been living there had known about it for centuries, but that's a subject for another video. Anyway, it would come to be known as Lake Malawi. Today, the lake is a hot topic of conversation among evolutionary biologists. Why? Because it has more than 850 species of just cichlids. Cichlids make up around 90% of all the fish that exist in the lake. If you have an aquarium, you're probably familiar with cichlids. There's diversity galore in the coloration, shape, and the diet of these vibrant fish. Lake Malawi really has the original DEI. Diversity, evolution, and ichthyology, the study of fish. But why do we see so much diversity in this one lake? The reason is a process called adaptive radiation. It's the rapid increase in the number of species that share a common ancestor. Which is great, we have a definition. But what would provoke such an extreme diversification of these fish? One cause is competition between male cichlids. Metriaclema imbengi is a beautifully colored speckled cichlid that has some aggressive tendencies, specifically towards other male cichlids. When given their own territory, you can bet they'll make an effort to protect it. When an imbengi male is forced to defend his territory, studies have shown that he'll do so more aggressively against males of his own species and males of other species that look like him. So there's some incentive to evolve differences in coloration so that cichlids that look like you aren't constantly attacked. Another driver of cichlid diversity in Lake Malawi is habitat, which seems weird considering they live in the same lake. But this lake is a whopper, almost 30,000 square kilometers. Plenty of room for several different types of habitats. For example, one study focused on the hunting preferences of two different benthic or bottom-dwelling cichlids, the flavescent peacock cichlid and a species from the genus Tremitochromis. Tremitochromis cichlids tend to use their sight for prey detection. The flavescent peacock, on the other hand, often uses its lateral line system. That's an extra sense that fish have along the sides of their body that helps them detect movement in the water. It's also a sense I very much wish I had. When assessing the prey detection abilities of these two species in varying levels of light, scientists found that our flavescent friend was able to detect more prey at lower light levels than Tremitochromis. When you think about their habitat, that makes perfect sense. Tremitochromis lives in shallower waters, typically less than 15 meters deep, whereas the flavescent peacock can live as deep as 120 meters down, in an environment where light levels are much lower than what Tremitochromis is used to. So the need to detect prey in lower light may have driven the evolution of a new species that could operate at greater depths. It seems as though this town is, in fact, big enough for the two of them.
Thanks to Incogni for supporting this SciShow video. Incogni is here to help you stay away from cybercrime and personal privacy breaches. Data brokers collect and sell personal information, including social security numbers, login credentials, home addresses, location history, and more. And having your personal information on so many databases puts you at an increased risk of cybercrime. You could end up with spam from the marketing agencies they sell your info to, and more serious identity theft. And that's what Incogni steps in to prevent. They reach out to data brokers on your behalf and request that they remove your personal data. And if a new record pops up, they'll automatically take care of it. So you're covered for as long as you use the service. You can also use the Family and Friends plan to add up to 4 members to your subscription so they benefit from the same exact service you do. Anyone can try it out for 30 days and get a full refund if you aren't happy with the service. So to take back your personal data with Incogni, use the code SciShow at incogni.com/SciShow or the link in the description and get 60% off an annual plan.
But competition and habitat aren't the only drivers of adaptive radiation. Diet is another huge one. There are cichlids that specialize in scraping algae off rocks and others that prefer insects. There are even cichlids that feast on the scales of larger fish. One kind of scale-eating cichlid, Docimotus evelinae, goes through a diet shift as it gets older. It starts out more like a cleaner fish, eating parasites and fungus. As it grows larger and its teeth start to change, so does its diet. It begins eating plankton, when it's available, during its adolescence. Finally, once it reaches its larger sizes, it has lost all its baby teeth and has gained bigger, pointier ones perfect for plucking chunks of skin and scales right off of larger fish. Picking on someone bigger than you may seem like a precarious way to live, but it seems to have worked for a few cichlid species. This specialization seems to have led to the evolution of a distinct set of teeth to match that diet. It's the kind of thing that, over time, can lead to a new species. These drivers of diversity can work especially fast in cichlids, since they're generating generation times are so short. Think of it this way. Lots of organisms, like us, have long generation times. Passing down traits to your offspring won't lead to the formation of a new species very quickly if you're only passing them down every 20 to 30 years. But some cichlids can reach reproductive age at 6 months to 3 years old. And with so many aspects of their lives, like habitat, behavior, ecology, etc., being so different, there's a lot of diversity to pass down very quickly. Some scientists suggest we may get a new species or two of cichlids in this lifetime, meaning we'll be able to watch the formation of a new species occur right before our eyes. And adaptive radiation is happening in more than just cichlids. One of the most well-known examples is Darwin's famous Galapagos finches I mentioned earlier. They show incredible diversity between islands, namely in their beak size and shape. This allows the different species to specialize on whatever food is available on their island. This was one of the observations that inspired Darwin's theory of evolution. Anolis lizards in the Caribbean are another great example. The lizards took over different niches all over the Caribbean islands, from the ground to the bushes, to the trunks and the tops of the trees. And now there are about 150 species of them. So it has happened in other places, but why Lake Malawi? Well, lakes and islands are the perfect setting for rapid speciation. Notice how the other two examples I mentioned were on islands? In such places, competition with other types of organisms is limited. Once the ancestral species arrives, there are usually tons of niches available for them to fill. They'd have a field day with all those opportunities. And like I said before, Lake Malawi is massive. With all that water, there's a lot of space for a lot of different niches and a lot of diversity. But if another type of fish got to Lake Malawi before the cichlids, would they have radiated the same way? Cichlids are wildly diverse in Lake Malawi, but they're also diverse across the world in the Amazon. Clearly, they've got this whole speciation thing down. With fish that seem to diversify quickly and a lake with enough space for the fish to do their thing, Lake Malawi and cichlids seem to be the dream team in the game of adaptive radiation.